All right, hi everybody. I'm Levi with Wausau Homes, Business Development Manager for the state of Minnesota. I'm actually here with Josh Gagne, Wausau Homes Stillwater, and we're just going to touch on a couple key points that we thought might be of interest for you, the other builders out in the network. And I'm just going to introduce Josh, and he's going to speak to some of the things that have been working well for him, some of his successes, and if you can use any of these ideas to help with your success, that's all we really want to do out of this video. So Josh, you're in your second full year here, and what can you tell us about kind of what you have in the ground and what you have coming up for the rest of 2018?
Yeah, first full year we did about 5 homes, and looking at doubling up that this year, shooting for 10, gonna fall around somewhere around 9 probably, but still hopeful for 10. We've got homes located in a development here locally in Stillwater, customers outside of the development with just separate lots that we're looking at building on, and then looking into other ways to supplement that volume and keep it going, and of course not really looking to double next year, but just kind of keep at 10 and add a few more homes, you know, get to 15, keep it manageable though.
So you don't lose your mind is what you're
saying.
Yeah. Well, I was talking to Richard or Richard and your mom, and they haven't had a day off in 30 days. Mm-hmm. And they're not excited about that, but they understand what it takes to win. Josh, you've just done a really good job, you and your team. You've built a couple spec homes. And real quick, give us some bullet points of kind of how that came to be and how it works for you. Because in talking with you, you had built one spec, sold it. Mm-hmm. You right after that one, you built another one. Mm-hmm. Appreciate that. And now it sounds like you're going to have a set day on July 26th that will coincide with the grand opening of that spec home, mm-hmm. which I just think is genius marketing, if you ask me. And then it sounds like if that spec sells, which it will, you're ready to do another one.
Yeah.
So what can you tell us that would help somebody who's considering maybe doing a spec?
It's a big financial commitment, of course, because you're paying for the cost of the construction of the home. What we found with the market these days, though, is there's a demand for housing out there, and banks are willing to give kind of somewhat established builders loans for specs or models. Of course, we're building them on the development, but I still think it would be beneficial to do them outside of a development, whether it be on a lot located where there's other lots for sale or in its own sub-development where you have the ability to buy multiple lots if that spec sells for you. The one nice thing about specs is it's builder driven, it's not customer driven.
Right.
So the turnaround's a lot quicker, you get to be in control of everything. A couple things we did to make our spec, I guess, as best as possible, or make it as marketable as possible, was work with an interior designer, work with a sales team. That way everything, kind of blends well together. It fits what the market's looking for, and it's reaching its maximum for resale value. The idea is to, get your money out of it, so not be building at cost.
Very good. So when you talk about a financial commitment, that's no secret, but how about did you go to get the financing for that?
My parents already had a lot of financing working with development. What we did is we had the head of the bank come in, local bank that we work with, ran through some numbers with them, sat down, got to know them personally, and gave them an idea of what we were looking to do, if that's something they were willing to give a loan for, and fortunately it worked out well. But it also helps, they take as much information from you as you take from them as well, so they're going to be wondering if you've got somebody, willing to market it and try to sell it as fast as possible, or if you're just kind of planning on building it and letting it sit there and sitting in it on the weekends and trying to sell it that way.
How has that worked out for you?
It doesn't work out well that way. It's nice if you got somebody professionally to list it, get it listed while it's being built, and even we do walkthroughs and tours during construction, Every weekend, the sales team is allowed in there to take customers through, and it's for sale while it's being built. So if somebody comes along and they don't want to, you know, wait for a home, for a new home to be built, it's a great opportunity for them to get in. It's already under construction. It's going to be done soon. They can just go ahead and buy it. So.
Outstanding. There's, you know, there's more to it than what you gave us. So you gave us a little snapshot. I'm sure this will spark some interest with some of the other builders out there that can reach out to you to get more information. Let's kind of segue into the development, and then I'd like to touch the last layer is your marketing team, because they've just done a knockout job for you. Mm-hmm. So the development that you're doing right now, sounds like you have about 12 lots out of 26, how many?
24.
24 lots, so you're over about half.
Yep.
And it sounds like you have 7 meetings in 7 days that have interest in this development, or at least interest in building.
Yeah, yep. We have 7 meetings here coming up. They're actually all for people outside of development, which is kind of nice. But, I mean, we have probably a group of anywhere from 5 to 10 couples per weekend come by for our open houses. So that kind of holds up with that, you know, 7 meetings over 7 days. We still have quite a few for the development as well. The nice part is they're filtered through the marketing team. And if you've got a good marketing team, you know, we had our 2 sales agents come up to Wausau with me and with you, take a look at the plant, get an idea of how to sell that to people and how to properly word how Wausau's building process works. So they are informed and ready to actually make a sale and transfer them to the builder. So there's no really misunderstanding when they're coming into our office. Mm-hmm. They already have a heads up of what's kind of going to happen.
What we do and how we do it.
Exactly.
Right. We won't go into, you know, the bad side of the sales team you had, but there's some definite stark differences.
Yep.
And for you at home watching this, it's all about finding the right team. And Josh has a couple pro tips, if you will, on how to find a marketing team and the percentages you should be expecting to pay. But, you know, Josh was explaining to me, if they're doing their job, you're more than happy to pay that percentage. So a couple pro tips on how to find, I mean, I know that in your case, there was some longevity with your current sales team and some proven track record, if you will.
Yep.
But one of the ideas you gave me was, find the local condos and who's the marketing team there. Maybe kind of start there.
Yeah. Our local sales team is actually a real estate team with Coldwell Banker Burnett. And he has on staff 2 to 3 employees that are strictly for marketing purposes. So it's a nice tie-in with, they've been in the real estate market forever. They have been making sales, but they also have an understanding of what they need to do for marketing. They have employees directly related to pumping out marketing pamphlets, brochures, advertisements to supplement what Wausau Corporate can do as well. And then it's just finding the right fit. I would suggest interviewing multiple companies, multiple sales teams. They're sales agents, so they're always going to give you a pitch. But the key is
newsflash:
looking into what they've done, their track record. Condo building is a great way. If you can find a successful condo building where it seems like they're just selling out right away, and there's a lot of interest in it, there's probably a sales team that's listed or associated with it. It would be worth your time to probably meet with them, see if you can strike up a relationship with them. Because a lot of those large sales teams that are working in large projects like a condo building, even large commercial buildings, are tied into residential as well and have a beat on investors and different ideas for developments and what they like to expand into. So it's kind of a nice relationship. For our marketing team, we pay out 4% to the real estate team if they bring in the buyer and also sell our house, so working both sides of it. If the customer comes in and they already have an established real estate agent that's not our sales team, then it's a 6% that we pay out, and that gets split between the 2 real estate agents. So it may seem like a lot, but if you're doing, you know, 10 homes, if they help you get to 10 homes or 15 homes a year, then you know, into your markup, but you're still going to be having constant cash flow. Right. And that's better than sitting there without houses to build.
Well, you did an amazing job with winter builds this year. I mean, you guys just don't stop. And obviously, winter builds is a hot button for Wausau Homes. Never stop. But you held up your end of the deal with that. And that must feel good knowing that you could keep the guys moving year-round.
Mm-hmm.
When you spoke about the marketing team, you said that they had the ability to bring other opportunities to you.
Mm-hmm.
Just know that if you're successful, successful people will probably try to find you, or you'll meet inevitably, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you just speak to the one example you just gave me with the gentleman that's looking, that has some money to unload, and kind of how that might work out for you.
Mm-hmm. So our realtor and our real estate team sells really high-end homes as well. Now they don't move as fast, but when you're working with that kind of clientele, a lot of the time you strike up a relationship and they have other funds that they're looking to invest into real estate projects or developments, things like that. What our specific example is, he has a customer that has capital gains of about $13 million that they need to allocate before a certain time so taxes aren't taken out of it and get reestablished on the market as an investment. So they're looking at different projects, different developments, but because they're tied in working with us and they enjoy the relationship they have, it opens the door for us to come in wherever that money or funds gets allocated, and you know, you get a foot in the door with becoming a builder at that development. You know, it doesn't mean we're going to be the exclusive builder, but it means we'll be one of the first ones to establish ourselves, you know, in that development. So.
Well, not only that, it's activity breeds activity, so now you have a marketing team that's actively promoting Wausau Home Stillwater in this new development.
Yep.
And just will never end.
Yeah.
So that's amazing. Josh, you do a great job at your set days and your marketing and just everything that you're doing. We're really excited you're part of the team. Is there anything else that you want to share before we kind of close this up?
I think that's a pretty kind of brief rundown of it. But if anybody has any questions or anything, you can always reach out to me, send me an email, give me a call, and I have no problem trying to explain or answer any questions.
Right. Well, there you have it, guys and gals. If you're thinking about learning more or what that would look like for your business to add a development or add specs, the benefits of having a proper marketing team behind you, Josh is a great resource, more than willing to help. And 26 years old, and he's doing a phenomenal job here in Stillwater, Minnesota. We appreciate your time, and we'll see you on the next one.